Chet Holmgren of the Minnehaha Academy Redhawks is the number one center and number four overall recruit in his class. He's listed at 7 foot 190 pounds, but he could easily be 175 pounds. Before I get into the video, I want to give a quick little breakdown on him as a prospect. I get the Porzingis comparisons. I've even heard the comparison of Dikembe Mutombo on defense and Kevin Durant on offense. He also kind of reminds me of Kevin Garnett at that age, except he's much weaker. Although in high school, if you guys remember, KG was probably just as skinny. So now let's go refer to our handy dandy cladogram to give you guys an idea of what kind of a player Chet Holmgren is. I would say ultimately he's going to belong to the power forward class, but he'd be at this point where he decides how he wants to deviate his trajectory. Is he going to end up a stretch forward in the mold of Kevin Durant, or is he going to be a true power forward like Kevin Garnett? He already said this himself in an interview. He does not define himself as a center or think of himself as a center. And with moves like this, you can see why. So I would say it's a little far-fetched to call him Kevin Durant on offense and Dikembe Mutombo on defense, but that's kind of going along the right lines. I think he's more of a Bol Bol on offense and a Marcus Camby on defense. He moves very well for his size, uses elite timing and his length to block shots. He's definitely comfortable shooting and handling the ball, but he needs to get stronger. And that's why I see him as more of a stretch power forward. He gets pushed out of position a lot, both on offense and defense. But, you know, just look at Kai Soto. That guy's probably put on about 20 pounds of muscle this year, and hopefully Holmgren can be about 210 pounds by the time he's a freshman in college. However, even though on draft night, Bol Bol was only 208 pounds, and Kevin Garnett was also freakishly skinny at that age, they both have slightly bigger frames to put on mass. Holmgren has a very slender frame, which isn't that big of a deal. Remember, Kevin Durant could not bench press 180 pounds once during his rookie combine, and that clearly did not affect his career at all. But now moving on to the main part of this video, let's take a look at how Minnehaha absolutely dominated Sierra Canyon, a team that we believed was the best high school team ever assembled, in the Chipotle Clash of Champions game in Minnesota. In the first half, Sierra Canyon, especially Kentucky-bound Brandon Boston, came out like greyhounds out of the trap. They started the game on a 10-2 run, where they were capitalizing with fast breaks off of turnovers. But both teams were going blow for blow, and the first half would finish with a tie score of 34-34. But this game was a tale of two different styles and two different halves. The adjustments made by Minnehaha Academy were far superior in the second half. As mentioned earlier, both teams came out playing incredibly fast, and this advantage would go to Sierra Canyon. That's the way they like to play, and even though the game was tied, they were controlling the pace. Especially when you have a team full of D1 guys and the sons of two NBA legends sitting on your bench, the more possessions you have, the better you'll play. However, the second half was all about the better executing and well-rounded Redhawks. Their game plan was to slow down the pace, and it made a significant difference. They implemented this strategy by switching to a 2-3 zone. This helped them twofold. It made Sierra Canyon have to execute in the half court, and kept their prize rim protector Holmgren as the team's goalie. He's an unbelievable shot blocker. But in the first half, he'd block shots and overextend, and then he'd be out of position to defend second chance opportunities. With their 2-3, they were able to keep Caden Johnson and Jalen Suggs in position to help with second effort defense. Holmgren finished with 12 blocks and really did a good job altering shots and discouraging penetration. So after Minnehaha decided to slow it down, Sierra Canyon attempted to speed them up by going into a zone press in the second half. In the first half, Suggs would try to push the pace, and 99% of the time, that would be a good idea. However, I don't think Sierra Canyon has ever been accustomed to playing where they can't overwhelm the other team. The second and third layer of their press didn't rotate very well, and Jalen Suggs, who's also the star quarterback for the school's football team, decided to slow down and rotate the ball side to side. The Gonzaga-bound Suggs, who reminds me of Derrick Rose, also had an amazing offensive game, finishing with 23 points. He essentially quarterbacked the entire offense in the backcourt, which was even more effective when you have two Division I football prospects on your roster, Caden Johnson and Terry Lockett. They also have their three-point shooter, Donovan Smith, who can spread the floor, and was able to make this unbelievable catch like a wide receiver. So this football strategy really suited them well. And as stacked as Sierra Canyon is, Minnehaha is just as talented. They have two top 10 prospects in Holmgren and Suggs, and they too have celebrity power with Hersey Miller, the son of Master P. The Redhawks would also outmaneuver the Trailblazers in the half court using their Veer offense. This is an offense you might have seen the Boston Celtics or Golden State Warriors run, but my favorite team to watch run it is Maccabi Ashdod under their coach Brad Greenberg. It's a weaving DHO offense that leads to multiple if-then read-and-react situations. It works really well to counter aggressive defensive pressure, like the type Sierra Canyon can put on a team. If your opponent has one weak defender, you can essentially weave your team until that player is the MIG defender, or the most important guy. In other words, the team's last help weak side defender. Then you simply attack that guy and make the appropriate read. Unfortunately for Harold Yu, he got exposed as the team's MIG. But by the end, the game wasn't even close, and Minnehaha Academy would win by a score of 78-58. Bronny would finish with 5 points off the bench, Brandon Boston led Sierra Canyon with 27, Amari Bailey looked pretty good, and Zaire Wade was dealing with some health issues. He finished this season averaging 4.3 points per game off the bench. But I believe this is still a very special team, and they can learn a lot from this loss. Before their tournaments got canceled, both teams were headed to their respective state championship games, so we might never get to see their full potential. But let us know what you guys think in the comment section below. Is Sierra Canyon overrated? Will they rebound from this loss? And how good are prospects Chet Holmgren, BJ Boston, and Jalen Suggs gonna end up being? If you guys haven't already, please like, subscribe, and share, and we'll see you guys on the next one.